Janet, because you are someone I don't want. And that's how, ladies and gentlemen, my version of How I Met Your Mother never started. Dear Toastmasters of the day and my fellow SHGNs, I see some of the people here who are happily married, just married, or waiting to get married. But when will I get a girl? We have to solve this today. So let me give you a brief about myself. I have been a very shy kid. So it was always difficult for me to talk to women. I still remember my first day in college. I was standing in registration line with a girl. Said, "Hey, what's your good name?" I thought about it for a while. Is my name really a good or not? But that girl was really hot, so I said, My good name is Rahul, but my better name would be a sweetheart. I don't know what happened, but she never just spoke to me again. Days passed, weeks passed, months passed, but my relationship a status was single. One day I saw a girl in my college cafeteria. She was cute, had a tattoo on her neck. I thought she might be my girl. So I walked up to her. Our eyes met. She looked at me from top to bottom, while I looked at her from bottom to top. She said, "What's your name?" Now, I knew not to repeat the same line which I said earlier. So I said, "Hi, my name is Rahul, but you can call me mine." She said, "Of course I would, but my mine is standing right behind you." I ran away from there like flash. But again, days passed, months passed, but this time I finally had a girlfriend. She was beautiful. Caring, but she had one nagging habit. She always used to tell me, Rahul, let's go out for shopping. Let's go out for travel. But I was a busy man. I used to work from Mondays to Saturdays. And all I wanted to do was rest. So one day I got irritated and I took her to a graveyard. She said, Rahul, what's this? I said, baby, this is a graveyard. People die to come here. I don't know what went wrong, but she broke up with me. Moving on to today, I finally have a girlfriend, but I'm not happy. You know the reason? Because she belongs to a different nation. Can you guess which nation that might be? All right.
Imagination.
Yeah. So that's my imagination. So today, my dear evaluator, don't give me feedback. I need you to use that pen and a paper wisely. Write the name and the number of a girl and give it to me. Thank you.
That was so good speech, which was full of humor.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks, Rahul, for the wonderful speech.
And Shobhit.
Now I would like to invite our second speaker, who is Lokesh. Lokesh will introduce his own speech. So welcome, Lokesh.
Thank you, Shobhit. good morning. I hope everyone are doing great. Generally, most of us have the problem to how to how to keep the conversation I'm getting message saying that the host asked you to start your video.
Yeah, please. You can start the video. By mistake, I put it off.
Sorry. So now can you see my video?
Yes.
Okay. So generally, most of us have the problem to how to keep the conversations going on and on, right? Say, for example, you went to any party or any function or any client gathering. There you met some people or you met any girl or boy, okay? So you want to talk to them and You want to know more about them. So somehow you start conversation with them. But however, at some point of time, you may feel that you are struggling to keep the conversation going on because you are not sure what to speak next, what to ask next, right? So finally, what happens? The conversation dies. I have faced this kind of experiences many times. And I'm sure that most of you guys also faced this kind of experiences, no? So there is a simple solution for this, to keep the conversations going on and on without constantly worrying about what to speak next, what to ask next. And it's really simple. All we have to do is we need to ask right kind of questions to the right people. Okay. In any conversation, generally there are two types of questions.
Just a second. Hello.
You can go on, Rupesh. Yeah.
Yeah. One is closed-ended question, and another one is a open-ended question. Okay. So, in closed-ended question, generally, if you ask, it's like you are interrogating someone, like you are questioning someone. Say, for example, if you ask someone, "Which color do you like? Which college you are studying? Which company you're working for," so on. A conversation basically is like riding a bicycle. So for riding bicycle, what do we need? We need two things. One is forward momentum and balance, right? So if you ask too many closed-ended questions, this applies breaks to your smooth conversation. You doesn't go forward in your conversation. This closed-ended question doesn't give a push required for your smooth conversation. On the other hand, open-ended questions. These open-ended questions generally prompt the people to talk more, and they think, they take pause, and they give their views, their thoughts, their advices, so on. For example, if you ask, what is the opinion on TISA, and what are you thinking about the online weekly SSG meetings like that. These open-ended questions gives you the push and balance required for your conversation to keep going on. Also, if you want to know more about any person, you need to ask these open-ended questions so that you can understand what the other person thinks and what he believes in. Right. So we need to ask the right kind of question to the right people. Say, for example, you are a software engineer and you are talking to a farmer. So if you ask the questions like about C, C++, Java under to the farmer, he may doesn't understand. So you need to ask the topics which are related to the other person. So finally, I would say that if we develop the skill to keep the conversations going on, we can become rich in terms of relationships. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, Lokesh, for the proper introduction of close and open-ended question. I am sure that we all have faced similar situation. Now I would like to invite our third speaker, who is going to tell us today about the importance of sports. The third speaker for today morning is Mr. Rakesh.
Thanks, Shobhit, for introducing me. My name is Rakesh, and today's topic that I am going to speak is on importance of sports. So, how many of you have played sports during school days? Can I have the count, please? Hello? Okay, so I can see some of your, most of the people have already played sports during the school days. So that's nice. And can you tell me how many of you still play sports? Well, that's good. So I see that most of the people have played sports in the school days, but few of the people have played sports are playing still. So how do you feel after playing sports? Do you feel energetic and or do you feel drained? Yes, that's good. So yes, it's obvious that after playing the sports, we feel energetic, and also we feel mentally challenged and physically active. So that's a part of sports that is important in our life. It rejuvenates our mind and body. So I would like to tell you a story about my school days. So during the school days, I used to play sports. And I can remember the time that when in the school days, I choose to wait patiently for the sports period to come. So it was a moment when the clock strikes at 3 p.m. At that time, we have our sports. So that was a very good moment for us. And I think so that's a part of everyone's memories that cherishes through. So apart from that, in the school days, we have our recess and the lunch break, and during that time, after finishing the lunch as soon as possible, we choose to play the sports, like playing cricket and some other sort of sports. So this refreshes our minds of our school days. So how many of you are feeling stressed after those 8 hours of your work or your business time? Do you feel that after 8 hours, how do you feel? Do you need to play some kind of physical activities and get stress free? How do you feel? Stress free? Okay, that's good. So it seems to be, the reason behind playing sports is not only as a hobby, but it's more than that. the point emphasizes on what does sports play, why does it has a vital role in our life. Today's life, as you all know, that it's a stressful life, very fast and paced life. We hardly have time to pursue our sports or any kind of physical activities unless and until you have a good business. So the people who are working, feeling stressed in this corporate world. So the idea behind playing sports is not only as a hobby, but also to make your mind stress-free, physically active, get more concentration. And apart from that, a good fitness. It also brings a good fitness and a good personality in your life. So that's what the sports is all about. Making you yourself active in any of the sports is as good as refreshing your mind. So a sound mind in a sound body, as you all know, that body is also important, not only the mind. So we should take care of the body as well. And for taking care of the body, we need some refreshments like playing sports. It can mean any kind of sports like cricket. As you all know that we are passionate about cricket and Indian people can play any time of sports like gully cricket, right in their in their society and also. So these things are very important. So always have a habit to play any kind of sports whenever you get free, at least 3 to 4 days in a week. That will refresh your mind, rejuvenates your body, and makes a good concentration. So that's all the importance of sports. I hope you people have you have been playing and you can continue to play these sports in your life. So the moral of the topic is a sound mind in a sound body. And so the importance of sports is very important in our real life. Thank you so much for your patience for listening this. And with this, I end my speech. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, Lokesh. It was a pretty good reminder to all of us that we should start or at least restart playing some kind of sport. Thank you. With this, I would like to bring everyone's attention back to the theme of the meeting that is utopia. Think what is your utopia and what steps are you going to take for that? I would like to give control back to Dipin to take the next step for the meeting.
Sobhit, what is the spelling of utopia?
The spelling of utopia utopia utopia.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Shobhit, and all the speakers for sharing their speech and their talks. And now I would like to hand over the stage to one of the special member in the group, which is Dinesh. So we have Dinesh, and he is going to share some of the techniques for the day. So let's hand over the stage to Dinesh.
Good morning, everyone. Nice to be here in the SAG meeting. Good morning.
Good morning, Dinesh.
I will try, Dipen, Shobhit, I will try to wind up my meeting well within 15 minutes. Just when it is 10 minutes, just let me know so that I start winding up.
Sure.
Okay. So this will not be a one-off episode. This will be a series, season one. Let's see what we can cover in season one. So this is the first episode of the season, and let's see how it goes. So every week, there's going to be one technique which we'll try to explore in depth. We will see what the technique is and what and all we will discuss about this. So today, basically, I will lay out, I will give you a trailer of what's going to come. So today is a trailer, as well as some part of first episode, or probably the first episode itself is an overview of what's going to come. So let me share my screen.
I'll just make you a co-host. Give me a moment, please.
Yeah,
I think you should be able to share your screen now.
Let me just can you see my whiteboard?
Yes, perfect. You're able to see it.
Yeah. I don't want whiteboard, I want notepad. Can you see the notepad? No?
I think you need to share your screen again.
Okay.
Maybe you can share the entire screen and then you can open the notepad.
Let me try that. Yeah, there you have it, finally.
Yes.
Okay, so how the communication is laid out is, you can imagine communication to be in the form of four concentric circles. So wherein... Dipen? You're
people not speaking, please stay on mute. No, I believe it was somebody else. Okay. So I have muted them. Please go on.
So basically, in the way I imagine, in the way I see things from my experience, I see the whole of communication as four concentric circles, you can imagine. The core part of it, or the foundation of it, the foundation of communication. This is something, take a guess, anything? What do you think is the core foundation for communication?
The
speech.
The message.
Cool. Wonderful, Shobhit. Yes. So content is the king. Content is the primary element. The core part of any communication as message is content. Without content, there's no communication. And along with content, are there any things which can be added in the core which are as important as content?
Self-belief system.
Okay, self-belief system. Okay, fine.
What do you want to say? You can say what the content
what the content you have can only be said if you have the sufficient self belief system.
Yeah,
am I correct?
Okay, you're there. Let me summarize everything in the core content, or the foundation part of any communication into three subcategories: the content, intent, and the state of mind. So these are the primary elements which are needed for any communication. Content can be considered as what you know. Intent is, what is your intent to communicate? What is the purpose? Whether you want to explain something and don't care whether the others understand, or whether you want to explain and ensure that the others understand, or you just want to vomit out. You don't care whether others get it or not. And this is a default mode wherein we all operate in. Just learn something and vomit it out. Whether other person gets it or not, we don't care. We want to vomit. We want to vomit well. That is so. Intent is very much important, and the intent should be always to make others understand what is there in your mind. You can use examples or anything, but intent is as much important as content. Third is state of mind. State of mind is your belief system as to from where you are communicating. It can be your confidence. It can be as to, are you speaking something which you have practiced, or speaking something which is good to understand, good to know what from where you are communicating? What is the source of your communication? Are you talking practical knowledge or some theoretical stuff? And state of mind is a combination of many things. Today, we will explore just one element of that. But for now, you just consider as three sub-elements. And first is content, intent, and state of the mind. During the upcoming sessions, we will go into each of this in a really detailed manner. Today, we will just hit upon one detailed aspect of state of mind. Second is tools to communicate. What are the tools to communicate? One basic tool which is needed to communicate.
Language,
yes. Language is enough to communicate. Language is very important. Without language, you may understand content, you have the right intent, your state of mind is wonderful, but if you don't have the right language or the set of words to communicate, it is useless. Along with language, what else?
Non-verbal methods also.
Yeah. Sometimes people will not understand your verbal methods. Then you'll have to show some signs with your hand so that they get the message. So non-verbal communication is also equally important. Very important. Yes. Yeah. Everyone speaks not only with their mouth, but through the body. So body language is equally important. Anything else you can think of?
Actually, I think that our speech systems should be okay. That is, our speech muscle, vocal cord, our tongue should be in okay condition.
Sorry, Vidyut Jad.
I would like to add here, Dinesh, sir. I mean,
All the
vocal as well as your body should be in rhythm. I mean, it should be at same place, so there should be no gap.
Fine. Yeah. Thanks, Rakesh. So Language is very essential, and you should also have non-verbal communication gestures. Also, there should be a structure or method to your communication. Without any structure, your communication will be lost. For example, now you can see that I am explaining things in certain way. There is a core, there is tools, there is communication, there is techniques. So unless there is some structure in what you want to communicate, it will not come out. People will not get what you want, and you yourself will be a little confused. So if you would have the language, but you would also need the structure in which your message is laid out. The structure or the method. Let's say everything is there, but still the third step, communication, is something different. It is different from language. It is different from structure, method. For example, let me, how many of you in the group know Java? Any? Rakesh, and along with Rakesh, anyone else? Or any other programming language for that matter, not only Java, any other programming language. Okay. So whichever programming language you know, for example, I will ask Aditya, how good are you in that programming language? What will be your answer? On a scale of 1 to 10, how good are you in Java? Assume Java is what you know, or the programming language that you know.
I would say like 6, above average.
Why 6?
Because the scope, like the content that you can actually learn is huge. But since like what I have to learn as a part of my job was a small part of it. So yeah, I could only get to know that. And like that is still not the 100%.
Okay. Thank you, Aditya. Thanks for that. Yeah. So one of my friends who was expert in Java, he was asked, how good are you in Java? The interview was supposed to be for an hour or so, but interview ended in 10-15 minutes. He was asked, how good are you in Java? You know what his response was? Any guesses? He was really good at Java. Let me tell you that. He said, Java is like my mother tongue. So after that interview, asked probably one or two questions, and he got it. He got the message. You can either say paragraphs, 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 no one gets it, or you can just make one statement and the other person gets it. So which side you want to be? You want to, you know, narrate stories, 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 and no one gets it like Rahul Gandhi, or just one statement and the message is put across in just one statement. So communication is about that. It is not about flowery language. It is not about, you know, being wonderfully dressed. These and all are good to have, cosmetic things. The main thing is communication is about, with minimum effort, you communicate what is needed effortlessly. That is communication. So that will come with experience. It should be effortless. You say something and the message is understood. Finally, you have the techniques, which are like slow speaking, pausing, voluntary stuttering. So you can see, you know, where we have to start from the core and move towards the techniques. That is what we will do. But always what we do is we start from bottom up, or we start from the techniques and we get stuck at that, because all these things are not even taken care at very minimal level. The core things, tools, communication, we are getting lost in the techniques alone. Techniques are important, but you should prioritize which is more important, work towards it, and gradually move towards technique. Okay, so far clear? So today, I will explore one very important foundation technique. Without foundation, all your castles will come down crumbling, even if you have practiced your speech therapy, voluntary stuttering, slow speaking for hours and hours and hours. If you don't have right core foundation, it is like you are on quicksand. So let us strengthen our foundation a bit. We will strengthen it over in our series. But today we will talk about one foundation technique, which is most important: power of the word. You will understand the importance of this in your communication. You would have heard casually people saying, I give you my word, or there are various meanings to it, but I want to drive home two main points out of it. When I say power of the word, you pay attention very seriously to every word that you communicate externally and every word that you communicate internally. It is true that your word creates your world. You are the live example of it. Whatever is your conversation externally or internally, your world is like that. If your conversation is positive with you and internally you have a positive outlook, so your word is your world in one short sentence. So be very careful. Don't ever say that it is difficult for me. Or you can say I don't know now, but if I understand it, it will be easy. There are ways in which you can actually put across what is your state of mind or what conversation you are having externally or internally. This is very important. Never ever have a conversation with anyone or with yourself, you know, where you consider yourself as a victim, weak. You shun all those things. Start from a zone where you don't know, then slowly progress further. And secondly, this is about your word. Second is the commitments that you make. That is one area where you actually give your word. It can be anything. It can be as casual as something that you speak to your family or to your boss or anywhere. This is when you give your word. In earlier, all of you would have heard this Hindi dialogue, Pran Jaye Par Vachan Na Jaye. There is a lot of stories to it. The history is laced with stories. People often give up their lives, but they'll not give up their word. Karna, he said to his mom that I will give you my the protection that he had, and he gave it. He ripped apart and he gave it. There is numerous stories. Bhishma once said, I will not marry, and he did not marry. So if you keep your word, the amount of power that you gain out of it is immense. You cannot measure it. Just keeping your word. If you say something and do it, get it done, the amount of power that you will gain out of it is something you have to witness yourself. Other side, this is very casual with the PWS. They say something and do something else. Very, very, very casually, everyone, they just imagine. If you don't respect your word, who else will? If you don't listen to yourself, who else will? If someone says that I will give speech in this week, you do it. Whatever you are prepared, not prepared. If you have said you will do it, you do it. Word is very important. It is what creates your world. And slowly you will reach a stage where when you say something, it will be as good as it is done. When you say something, people should get the message that he said it, so it should be done. There's no doubts about it. This technique alone is enough for you to achieve what you want. No other technique is needed. One technique alone. In earlier days, people, you know, the answer to question of who you are, the answer was, you are your word. That was the one line statement of your identity, your existence. You are nothing but your word. So this is the one of the foundation technique. This is like the foundation over which if we build upon other techniques, it will be easier for other things to, you can quickly gain other things without a sense of commitment to yourself or to what you say. Whatever you do, it will take eons. It will take time. It will take ages. What you can do it in probably months, you will take years because the foundation itself is weak. How can you progress fast without a strong foundation? So this is the technique for the day. This is the message for the day. There's a tremendous power to the word that you say, that you give, and you ensure that it doesn't leak it out. You are your word and you do everything in your capacity to keep your word. And be careful and observe carefully what you utter outside and inside. These two messages, please take home for today. The other things we will cover in the, probably the core foundation will cover in 2-3 sessions. The tools will cover in 2-3 sessions. And then probably techniques will cover in 5-10 sessions. We will explore every technique under the sun, under the techniques. That's on the power of the word. If you have a couple of questions, I can take. After that, we can wind up.
Yeah, Dinesh, actually, I have a question. You know, we always, I mean, try to slow down our speech and, you know, get the control. But most of the time, it doesn't work in the same way that we may expect. Like, after making your mind as well, we are unable to recreate the same thing in the real world, like while giving the live speech or, you know. So how do you think that we could get this similar, like inside and outside should be similar, whatever we create?
See, we'll come to those techniques in the coming session, but one line answer for you. If you think you cannot do it in live, you cannot do it. If you think it is difficult for you. Why you can't speak slowly when you want to? What is that is stopping you? Can't you just be aware that you want to speak slowly and speak it? Why it is difficult? Practice it in the SHG and it will happen in the live session. Take out that it is difficult. Take out that it is difficult. Make it easy. Practice it and it will happen. Why it cannot happen? Whatever you want, why it cannot happen? Make it happen. Don't stop pretending to be weak. Stop pretending to be weak. Stop pretending that things are out of control. Take control. Manifest whatever you want.
Yeah, thank you.
One more question and we can call it. We can end the technique of the week session.
Dinesh, I had one. What do you do when you are in a state of confusion, like whether to give your word or not? So how do you handle that?
You honestly say that you are confused and cannot give your word now, probably will take more time. That is how you should go about. When you are confused, you shouldn't give your word and later get into a mess. If you are confused, you say that I'm confused. I need things to settle down. I need things to clarify. So probably I will give a plan for my plan at a later date. When you're confused, you don't commit. Or you can say that this is a draft commitment. Don't consider this as final, because I have few things to check it out, which I haven't checked it. So that way, right, you know that you haven't committed. There are riders. That's how you should proceed. And if by any chance you're not able to keep your commitment, it happens. You should upfront before the, you know, don't wait for the milestone to slip by and then say that, sorry, I couldn't do it. Please, whenever you get it that you will not be able to keep the commitment, don't delay the communication. Say that you're not able to meet it because of these reasons, and this is the new date. For whatever, it's not only for official purpose, for whatever reason. That way you maintain the hygiene, not that, chalo, wo toh bhool gaya, abhi, main bhi bhool jata. That way you don't screw up others, you only screw yourself. no one ever forgets. Even if everyone forgets, you never forget about your commitment. And it will eat you like termite within if you don't do it. I think we can, that should be enough for today. We will explore a few things in the coming weeks. Thank you, everyone. Back to you. Back to you, Shobhit, Dipen.
Thank you.
That was so interesting, Dinesh.
One we line I would add, Shobhit. One line I want to add.
All right, yeah.
See, utopia, you can create it. Utopia, with the power of the word, a utopia is never far. With the power of the word, a utopia is never far. So with that, I will conclude it.
that's absolutely correct. Utopia is always in the present. With that, I would like to move to the second section of our meeting, which is table topics. And for today, the table topics master is Aditya. So let's welcome Aditya.
Hello all. I would like to welcome all of you to the table topic session for today. I'll just give a quick brief. A table topic session is basically an extempore speech. So what we will do here is that we will give you a topic, and you will have 10 seconds time to think, and then you will have to speak on the topic from 1.5 to 2. Minutes, and I will explicitly have to cut you out if you exceed the time of 2.5 minutes. So we will take up we will give a priority to all those people who have not spoken so far. So how we will pick up volunteers is through chat. So all those who would like to speak can put up their names in the chat, and we will call the people in the same order we have in the chat.
We also have an option to raise the hand. So all the people who want to take part, they can raise hand also.
Yeah. Okay, Sudhanshu, I guess, is the first one. Okay, so Sudhanshu, can we have you?
I think Arpit had also pinged before me.
Arpit said yes, so I was not sure what I thought he's saying yes to what the person has said above. But anything would do. We have enough topics. So let's start with you only, Sudhanshu.
Yeah, sure. No problem.
Okay. So the topic would use describe how would a PWS utopia look like. I would repeat. Describe how would a PWS utopia look like.
So before I start, I want to just check that if I know the meaning of this word right. It means that the word is in your control the way you want it, right?
No, like the world is in a very perfect state. Sab mast hai duniya mein. Kuch bhi gadbad nahi.
According to you, right? Because there will be so many opinions.
Yeah, but usme like they have solved all the problems. They have handled this case as well. So the world is perfect for everyone.
Okay, yeah, got it. Thanks.
Like that is what I think. Yeah. It is open to interpretation. Anything that you feel like is okay.
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Aditya. To start with, I feel a state of utopia for a PWS would be a first and foremost thing would be that will help all of us will be to accept this stammering among the society. To do that, what I feel is because if we see now in our real world, more than acceptance, people are not aware about it. So if they are well educated or well, if there was a awareness right from their childhood or beginning phase of their life, any PWS they meet, they will not have a different opinion about that person, because they already know that this is something that exists in the world, and they don't have to react in a different manner. So yeah, this is the first thing I would say. A utopia state for a PWS should be, and I hope you all are agree with that also. Another thing is, even if society is, society knows about us or knows about this this problem or a speech impediment, we as a PWS should also have some responsibility to overcome it. It may not be gone 100%, even if we practice day in, day out, but to some extent we can try to improve this speech. So this is what I think this association called TISA was also found, because we all believe that there is a way to overcome this problem and manage it somehow, that we are able to communicate to the others. And yeah, number three, I would say is we should not always think about we have some problem, we cannot do anything. So that would anyway be gone, that feeling or thought I'll anyway be gone if we have a utopia kind of state in this world. All in all, it is a part of learning, even for a person with stammer or the rest of the world. We all should cooperate each other, because even if we think we have a big problem in our life.
Yes, Sudhanshu, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Thank
They're
you.
Already like 3 minutes. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
So we'll move to the next person. I might take some time to figure out the chat, like Zoom is new. Sudhanshu and Tapan sir. Arpit, do you want to take a stab? Like Sudhanshu was saying that you were prior, so
probably. Yeah, I was like trying to ping, but it's okay if I get a chance later.
No, it's fine. So we'll go with you. So next topic, the topic for you is why.
Can you just tell me what is the time limit?
Time is 1.5 to 2. Minutes. And I'll stop you after 2.5.
Okay. Thank you.
So the topic for you is, why can't India become a utopia ever? I'll repeat, why can't India become a utopia ever, according to you?
Okay, so in my personal opinion, what I think that in India can never become a utopia because of the diversity that exists in our country. in our country, India, we often see that some people are having these kinds of thoughts. Some are having modern thoughts. Some are having traditional thoughts. So I guess that if we will try to compile like the if we'll try to take into compilation the thought process and everything of every individual, then there will be a lot of difference that would exist in between, right? So that might be the first reason why I don't think that in India can ever become a utopia or something like that. So apart from that, the second thing is that what I feel that all the traditional foundations that we are seeing in India, those things definitely can cause some kind of a trouble to make India a utopia place, because whenever any individual, any youth, he is trying to take away a very important step or a very modern step, then obviously those traditional foundations will come, and they will try to impose some restrictions in his way, in his pathway. So I guess that these two are the main reasons why in India can never become a utopia. Thank you, Aditya.
Thank you so much, Arpit. You were also perfect on the time as well. So next we'll have Tapan sir.
Yeah.
So Tapan sir, the topic for you is, what according to you is that one thing, if eliminated, could help us the most in turning our world into a utopia? I'll repeat, what according to you is that one thing, if eliminated, could help us the most in turning our world into a utopia?
So utopia, as you said, this perfect state of the world. And you know, the perfect state of the world is started from the human being only. That the people who stay in the world, that they should be in the perfect state of mind. So once the people in the world, they are thinking right, or they are doing right, so automatically the country or the nation or as a world as a whole, it will become a utopia. So we make the world. So it is our individual responsibility, I feel, to do something for the world. So in our thinking level, first we have to correct our thinking level. So if we think right, then I think that we can act right also, because all the action started from our thinking. So, but internally, if we thinking something and if we then doing something, so it will not communicate to the world. So if our thinking is very positive, you can say, if our mindset is like a helpful nature, and then that the positive vibration also goes to the world and it will heal the world as a whole. So I think like that, if because there are so much pain in the world, so much suffering in the world, and because of this pandemic also, people are in panic. Though they say the virus is very mild, it will not affect too much, but because of the panic and because of the stress level, your immunity is coming down. But other factors also there, I'll not deny that. So that's all I have to say. First, we have to correct ourselves. Then if we correct ourselves, then utopia will come automatically. Thank you.
Thank you, Tapan sir. So next, I guess we do have the name in chat, but one person has raised his hand also. And we can't tell the sequence because there is no timestamp in the hand raising. So I'll take Akash next. Yes, Akash, I've seen your hand. You're pinging it repeatedly.
Yeah,
So just one thing here, like I tried to keep all the topics as per the theme, but like the theme was a bit hard for me, so I was not able to come up with 10 topics, so it's kind of a mixed bag. So some top topics would be out as well, and the first one is for you, which is not coherent with the topic, but it is coherent with the experiences. So yeah, so the topic for you, Akash, is tell us your most embarrassing stammering incident. I'll repeat, tell us your most embarrassing stammering incident.
Okay, first thank you for giving me chance, and yes, the most embarrassing I might say I would say it embarrassing earlier before joining PISA, but after understanding what is acceptance or these things that what you want to do, you should do, and don't limit yourself to your restrictions. So I would say my embarrassing moment as my learning incident to make me more hard, you know, to fight back once more. So I was in school in class 9th or 10th. There was oral assignments going on, and there were two or three children who are very, you know, mischievous and always make fun of me, of this stammering. So whenever I got called up for oral assignment, you know, they just booked their first benches, their group, and they just come up right on my face, and they just you know, notice each and every movement of my mouth, of my eyes, where I stuttered, you know, or I get blocked. And at that time, I was also not, aware of acceptance or prolongation or bouncing techniques. So that was a thing, and they just noticed me, and they just laughed. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Aditya.
Complete your story. You still have 30 seconds of grace left.
Yeah, so they always make laugh, and in front of all class, in front of teacher. But yes, it is a learning experience, you know, as I called it earlier. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Akash, for sharing that story. And yeah, it always takes a lot of courage to share your personal experiences. Yeah, thank you so much. So next we will have I'd like to call Roy. Roy, can we have you?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you also help us with your name first? If you are okay with it.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi, Roy. Okay. So the topic for you is, so were you did you attended the NC that took place the previous weekend?
No, I did not attend. And really, this is my first in there, and I have no idea about that.
Great. So we hope like your first session you feel comfortable and welcomed. So yeah, so I'll give you other topic. So the topic for you would be name one person who has been the most supportive in regards to your stammering. I'll repeat, name one person who has been the most supportive in regards to your stammering.
Okay, so if I want to say the name will be Chopul Roy. I mean, this is my name. I think I am the person who is helping me and who is supporting me a lot for overcoming that. And I think who stammer, everybody should be his or her best friend and the most supported person. Because if we do not support ourselves, nobody will not support. At first, we have to accept, and then we have to support ourselves a lot. That yes, I am very good now, and I am overcoming that, and I am developing, and should support every time, every situation, every moment. That I want to say, okay, thank you.
Thank you. So next we will have Vidyut. Vidyut, can we have you?
Vidyut, yes.
Okay. So I guess, were you a part of NC? Like, I have two questions that are around NC, so I would love to have people over there.
Actually, I am a service holder, so my service period is from 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. and 2 hours break. And I sometimes have attended the last NC program, not fully attended, but I sometimes have attended.
Sure. No problem. So I'll give you a topic apart from it. So the topic for you would be a PWS in Utopia or the best speaker in Dystopia. What would you choose?
Best speaker.
Yeah. So I'm saying a PWS in Utopia or the best speaker in Dystopia. What would you choose? And to help you with the word Dystopia.
I will choose the first topic. What you have said, I will choose the first topic.
Sure.
Okay. Yes. So what I at first good afternoon to every participant here, also for good hosting of you. So the meaning of Utopia is a imaginary place. That is a PWS. That is, he can able to talk fluently every time. And he have enough strength, enough self-belief system to talk to everyone, to stranger, to known people, unknown people. And he, at that place, he is free to talk to everyone. So I think that every PW has cannot imagine that place, because a PWS may stammer sometimes, he can be fluent sometime, but with in a stage situation sometimes he stuttered. So we have to work on our tools, techniques, also what we have learned from any stammering cue center, also from this group also, so that our target will be to form a utopia place where we can able to talk freely, very cool and in a calm manner, also try to talk in a fluent manner, also present age, my present age is about 45 years. I started a lot during since my childhood, in my school life, in my college life, and then I have learned something, how to control my stammering. That is, I do so many tools, techniques in every day. That is deep breathing exercises, slow reading practice, vocal exercises. And I am talking to too many people, unknown or known people. And in this way, I am trying to strengthen my self-belief system so can I can form a utopia of the PWS. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you. And well said. And in the interest of time, we will take only one more table topic. And for that, I'll call the person who I know was a part of the NC so that I can use one of those two questions. So Pankaj, can we have you? Pankaj.
Pankaj, yeah.
Pankaj, we know that you are there.
Yeah.
Okay. So, hi. Yeah. So the topic for you would be share your best experience in terms of a talk or a session in the NC 2020.
Okay. Can you repeat?
Yeah, sure. So can you share your most favorite experience in terms of a talk or session as a part of the NC 2020? In other words, what was your best, what was the best talk or any session that you found in the NC 2020?
The session which I love the most was the first day. Raja sir told about his experience by the way, can I speak in
yeah sure anything.
मुझे सबसे अच्छा मुझे राजा सर का लगा क्योंकि क्या सर ने एक बात बताई थी कि वो क्या ये क्या स्टेमिंग के उसे ये आप कभी सेकंड पर्सन से सिंपथी गेन करने की कोशिश मत करना क्योंकि वो चीज ये आपको आपके 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 अंदर सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस बिल्ड नहीं करेगी. बाकी मैं क्या अपनी लाइफ में ये सिंपथी गेन करने की कोशिश करता था तो क्या मुझे ये वाला पॉइंट ने ये वो पॉलीमिमी है. दूसरा मुझे सबसे अच्छा ये वो आईपीएस सर आईपीएस सर का था जो क्या जो सर ने मतलब सर ने
पंकज थैंक यू सो मच गेट अप ऑन टाइम थैंक यू वेल सेड
हाय आदित्य यू नो एनी
any chance to me?
Next time, I'll forward that question to the main
yeah,
person.
Yeah, yes, please go. Can have for Amarna sir also. I can have topic
for him if you have. Sorry, I didn't hear you, Dipen. You but can we go ahead?
I think you can go on if you have a topic. Am I audible, Aditya?
Yeah, you. Breaking in. Just give me a thumbs up or thumbs down. Yes or no. Okay, okay.
Yeah, please go on.
Yeah, yeah, you are audible. So, Amarnath sir, the final topic for you would be, what would you think would be the emotional utopia state for a PWS? So, in other words, like what would be the best emotional state a PWS can be?
Yeah. Thank you, Aditya, for the topic given me. Yeah, the best emotional stage for PW is the best emotional stage is to calm the mind. So whatever the situation is there, you please carry with the calm mind and controlling our anxiety. So for that, we have to do more practice and more concentrate on meditation. So with proper meditation and some proper breathing exercises, you can get the control state of mind at any situation, at any condition. So do proper meditation every day, can get that stage of mind, and the mind will remain as in every situation for the control the situation. So like in presence of audience or in the public places, there are a lot of crowd. So at that places, we may automatically lose our control, and we get the anxiety and fear also. So for in that stages, so our we are try to keep calm mind and cool mind. So for that, we have to do every day meditation at least half an hour. Our mind will remain as and keep us to calm stays. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So thank you all for active participation in the table topic session. I hope you all had fun, and I'm very sorry if there are people who did not got a chance to speak, but we have to respect the time that we have. So yeah, I'll give the mic to Shobhit to take it forward. Thank you, everyone.
Can I ask one round of applause for Aditya for organizing it so systematically.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you all, Aditya, Dipen, Shobhit, and all. Thank you very much. Bye.
Amarnath sir, we also have the feedback form. So if you can please help us to fill the feedbacks also. It will help us to choose the best role takers and the speakers. So I have pasted the link in the chat window. You can open it, and I would urge every one of you to please go through it and help us to choose the role takers, the best role takers. Yeah. Over to you, Shobhit.
Thanks, Dipin, for that. That necessary information. With this, I would ask our general evaluator to present us with the report of the meeting on how did we do. Welcome back Dipin.
Thank you, Shobhit. Wow, what a meeting. I really appreciate the way Shobhit has conducted the meeting. He has set the theme with a smile, utopia. Everything is perfect. Well, if I speak about my opinion, then when I was thinking about the topic and when I was thinking about the theme, utopia, I thought, if everything is going to be perfect, what will I do? What will be left for me to better every day? Okay, so with that, but I can add, in this meeting, everything has been run in such a perfect manner by all the role takers, starting with Shobhit. He set the meeting, he started the meeting with setting the agenda, with a smile, with a greeting, and a nice background out there. So a very good job done, Shobhit, while entertaining and while transitioning from one phase to another. What better have been done in order to earn more points? Look, this is an age of infotainment, right? So along with the information, the Toastmaster of the day, they can bring in the energy into the group so that it can keep everybody engaged. So a bit of activity and anything sort of that, it could have bring theme and hosting to a little more light thing, right? Okay, otherwise a very well. Moving on to our first speaker, Rahul. Rahul, if I can have you on stage, please.
Yeah.
Can I see Rahul?
Yeah, I'm there.
I would urge everyone to switch on their video so that we can see them. Hey, Rahul. Hi. Then, make a girl. So, I can relate to your story, man. Although, you did had some some very moments which everybody of us could relate to. And at the last also, you did end with your girlfriend in imagination. But I just hope that your dream, your imagination would come true someday. But man, what a speech. What a speech. You started with a very good conversation. And then you had a lot of clarity in your voice. And at the same time, you did entertain with us with a lot of vocal variety in your speech. And I believe every one of us had seen the various body movements and the non-verbal part of communication, which Rahul had used very wisely to engage the audience. So yeah, a very well done job there. A few things which I realized, which you can work upon. At times I felt that you have been very stiff. So yeah. You can just ponder a bit on that area. That would bring a little more liveliness to your speech. Otherwise, a very well job done, and we look forward to more speeches from you. Now, moving on to our second speaker, Lokesh. Lokesh, are you still there? I can see Lokesh. Yeah, hi, Lokesh. So, you can always see Lokesh with a wonderful smile. The way he starts the speech and the way he sails through his entire speech with lot of calmness, lot of pauses, and stressing on the right words in order to ensure that he is putting weight on the right word in order to emphasize.
So a very good job done there. And yes, he did very well help us understand that what are the two ways of conversation and what could be a better way. So a very well job, well done, a very good job done there.
Thank you.
Lokesh, yeah, since you are a seasoned speaker, what I would also want from you is, in order to engage your audience in a more better way, you can a little more of innovative ideas. Maybe you can also include some of your body language or vocal way to an audience more. So that would be icing on the cake. Otherwise, a very good job, and we really enjoyed the way you have shared your experience with us.
Okay. Thank you.
And now we move on to our next speaker, Rakesh. Rakesh, yes. Hi, Rakesh.
Yeah, hi, Deepin.
Hi, Rakesh. So, importance of sports. I really love the way Rakesh opened his speech with a smile and some questions worth pondering for all of us. And he did made us realize how from our school days to now, we have enjoyed the sports, but still, we did not make out enough time in order to keep up that enjoyment. So he did made us realize whole series of questions. And I did see Rakesh attempting vocal variety in his speech. So that all kept us engaged throughout the speech. A few areas which can help us to take your speech to the next level, it could be there are you have used the word like, you know, so, I hope so. So those kind of words can be replaced with pauses. Even the best speakers in the world, they use pauses very wisely in order to let the flow of thoughts come. So you can also ponder on the same areas in order to take your speech to the next level. Otherwise, a real good job done, and we wish and we hope and we look forward for more speeches from you.
Thank you.
Now,
Deepin, thanks.
Yeah. Now moving to our table topic master, Aditya. I can see a nice t-shirt of a flash. Aditya entered the table topic, entered the Toastmaster meeting with his table topic like a flash. And he took over the entire stage. I was really impressed by the way he started. He started with briefing well to the audience about what table topics are, what is the importance of that, and what every participant can attempt during a table topic, like taking a pause and then structuring their thoughts. So he did explain the objective and the importance and the way to go forward. And and there were a lot of topics which are worth pondering. So again, a good job done there. Now the areas wherein you could have done a little better, or you can think of adding them in future. As I said, this is an era of infotainment. So a little bit of more energy or any activity, it could have make it a little bit more interesting to the audience. Otherwise, a very good job done there.
Thank you.
And to all the table topic speakers, they have really, really done well. Now I would like to hand over the stage to Dinesh to share any of the feedbacks he has about the speech, about the meeting. But before that, I would urge all the people one more time to have a look at the feedback form and fill in the feedbacks so that we can decide on the best role takers. So far, I have received only 5 responses while we have 11 people in the call. So I will hand over the stage to Dinesh. And meanwhile, I will expect more feedback from people. Dinesh, the stage is all yours.
Thank you, Dipen. I think you have summarized the proceedings of the meeting very well. Shobhit has led the meeting in a fantastic manner. He's always smiling, and it is quite a rare sight to see a PWS smile as often as Shobhit. Let the stumbles come, but everyone keep your smile on like Shobhit. And the speakers of the day were really wonderful. Rahul was at his a flirtatious best, I would say. He was flirting with the topic and many other things as well. That's the beauty of life, you know. Don't take anything as seriously. Just play around. And I like the way Rahul played around with this speech. And Lokesh was very, you know, he was going at his own sweet pace. That was very nice to see. He explained like how you need to continue your conversation. I think it's a very good topic for a community like us, and very apt topic he chose, and he communicated that very well. Then Rakesh, the topic which Rakesh took, that sports is an essential part of us. He expressed that well. With more speeches, he will get better. But I can say that he is already in a utopia now, wherein sports is a very important element. If you put your effort in sports, it will reflect in your speech as well. So overall, I like the concept and the content of Rakesh. He stood up and he communicated well. He expressed what he wanted to express in a very, very, very good manner. Then table topics. I think Aditya was really calm, composed. He gave everyone his time. He was very, very well structured. He knew whom to call out, whom not to call out, and to buzz at the right times. He intervened when needed. I think he was really calm, and he was well in control of the ongoing meetings. And Dipin, coming to you, I think you have just captured the gist of the meeting very well. No one could have captured it the way you would have captured. And it is overwhelming to see the way the meetings are being organized so well. I think we can give the professionally run Toastmasters a run for their money. We can parallelly set up another association, or we can be part of Toastmasters, but very well organized meetings. Keep going at it, everyone. Keep going at it often. And all of you are doing wonderfully well. I think if this is not a utopia, what else is? Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, I have also shared the best role takers' names with you. So if you can please go ahead and announce that also, Dinesh. You can open the chat and I have shared that with you.
Okay. So best speaker goes to Rahul. Rahul, naam to sunai hoga.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Rahul, for the best speakers. The best table topic goes to Sudhanshu, Tapan and Akash. Tapan is a veteran speaker. Sudhanshu is also experienced. But Akash, on debut, this is your first meeting or second meeting?
I have attended Hangouts earlier. But on Zoom, it's my second or third year.
Yeah, congratulations, yeah, Akash. I think you spoke very well. Keep attending and keep speaking. You can try prepared speeches in the coming weeks. You're doing well. And role taker, Shobhit is the man. He is the man of the day. Good job, Shobhit. Congratulations. Over to you, Shobhit. You can...
Thanks, Dinesh, and everyone else. I think we are already seven minutes past the timing. So I would like to ask if someone wants to share something, and if not, we can close the meeting for